When performing a sulfite test, it's important to use a sample cooler to properly cool the sample to room temperature before testing. If the sample is too hot, the starch indicator will degrade from blue to brown. It's also important to run the test immediately after you've collected your sample. The sulfite concentration will decrease the longer you wait, leading to lower results. First, we'll run the test on a properly cooled sample. Add one drop of phenolphthalein indicator and swirl to mix. The sample should turn pink. Next, add starch acid indicator powder, one scoop at a time, until the sample color changes from pink to colorless. Swirl the vial after each scoop to properly dissolve the powder. Once the sample has turned colorless, add two more scoops of powder and swirl to mix. The next step is to perform the titration. Add your titrant one drop at a time, swirling the vial after each drop. Be sure to count the number of drops during this step, and remember to hold the bottle vertically for a consistent drop size. Continue adding titrant and counting the number of drops until the sample color changes from colorless to blue. We will now run the same test on a hot sample. Add one drop of phenolphthalein indicator and swirl to mix. The sample should turn pink. Next, add starch acid indicator powder, one scoop at a time, until the sample color changes from pink to colorless. Swirl the vial after each scoop to properly dissolve the powder. Once the sample has turned colorless, add two more scoops of powder and swirl to mix. The next step is to perform the titration. Add your titrant one drop at a time, swirling the vial after each drop. Be sure to count the number of drops during this step, and remember to hold the bottle vertically for a consistent drop size. Continue adding titrant and counting the number of drops until the sample color changes from colorless to blue. You will notice that because the sample was not properly cooled, the starch acid indicator powder has degraded from blue to brown, and we are unable to achieve an accurate endpoint.